Okay, so hello guys, this is a problem hacker and called calendar module. So the input format is, or rather the date, they are just giving us a date that is in the format of month, day, and then day, no, date and year, and we have to print the day on that particular date. Okay, so for that we'll need calendar module. So I'll open PyCharm and import calendar. Okay, and we have to take it in the format of month, day and year. So I'll just name it MDY, so that will be easy. I'll just take the input in the format of, in form of a string, and after that I'll split that string into a list by spaces. So MDY.split. So what this statement will do, it will split MDY string by spaces and it will add them into a list MDY. I've named the list as MDY. So list with the element with index 0 will be month, the element with index 1 will be date, and the element with index 2 will be year. So I'll just assign it. So suppose I'm naming month as mm equals to, and I have to convert it into an integer as well. So I'll just write int of MDY of 0. So it will store 0th element of that list in month, and similarly for day, and again convert it into an integer, MDY of 1, and year. You can name it anything. It is simple for me, like MMDDY, that's why I've named it like that. MDY of 2, okay, fine. And after that, I have to convert this, or I have to print the day. So for printing the day, we can use calendar module. For that, I'll just use the function weekdays, or calendar.weekdays. It is calendar.weekdays. Dot weekday. Okay, and in that we have to enter first element should be year. See, they are already suggesting us year, month, and then date. So my year is y, and after that month, and then date. Okay, and suppose, and see, this is where it is interesting. See, when c equals to, when after this, when the all these functions get executed, then c, if c equals to 0, then it is a Monday. That is Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. It will start from 0. So c equals to 0 means Monday, c equals to 1 means Tuesday, c equals to 2 means Wednesday, and so on. It continues up to c equals to 6. So from c equals to 0 to c equals to 6. So now we just have to print it. So for doing that, we have to use if conditions. So if c equals to 0, then print Monday. If c equals to 1, then print Tuesday. So I have already written it so that I don't waste my time on it. So I'll just copy it and paste it here. So see, if c equals to 0, c equals to 1, Monday, Tuesday, and caps lock, okay, fine. So I'll just check if our code is right or wrong by the sample input on the website. Okay. And the answer should be Wednesday over here. Okay, Wednesday, fine. If the logic is right, I'll just copy the whole code and paste it on the current platform. Okay, all the test cases are right. Okay, there's no problem. Thank you.